Good afternoon, everyone. Excited to see so much excitement in the room and people already mixing and mingling. I'm Gabriel Seidman, Director of Policy here at the Ellison Institute, and I'm really thrilled to welcome you here on behalf of both the Harvard Chan School of Public Health, as well as the Institute for our event, Digital Frontiers in Public Health. This event is actually the Institute's first event in partnership with another organization since we opened the building during the pandemic. And I have to say, it is really great to be in person with people. Yeah. When I joined the Institute, it was about a year and a half ago, and we were still in that phase of the pandemic where we were coming into the office, but we were on Zoom with people in the room next door. And this is a lot nicer than that. You'll remember, of course, at that time, the country was undergoing its biggest vaccine rollout probably ever. And the federal government at the time was using data from the United Kingdom and Israel to inform our COVID vaccine and treatment policies. Here in the United States, where we have the strongest medical systems probably in the world, we had to get data from another country to inform our domestic health policies. I actually encountered a similar issue firsthand in my own medical care. At my annual physical last year, right after I moved to California, I learned that my doctor's record system had a record of my COVID booster dose, which I had received in a pharmacy here in Los Angeles, but not of my first two COVID vaccines, which I had gotten back home in New Jersey. It turns out that my doctor could automatically pull data from California's immunization registry, but not from other states. Now, thankfully, in this case, that was not a very serious issue. It was just routine clinical care. But imagine if I'd been missing that data at an emergency room visit or at a critical meeting about a serious clinical condition with my doctor. Things could have been much more serious. And right now, one out of every three people delays or forgoes medical care simply because of an administrative issue, like missing information in their medical record. And the rate for people who skip or delay medical care is even higher for low-income people and people of color. In the lead up to this event, my colleagues and I found 9 different reports from the federal government and leading think tanks, all calling in one form or another for a nationwide health data ecosystem. The latest of these reports from the Center for Strategic and International Studies came out two weeks ago. All of these reports show us that we have reached consensus as a public health and medical community that we need a stronger nationwide health data ecosystem. And we know that the technology to build this system and share data in a privacy-protected and secure way already exists. We also know that our current regulations and incentives do not support that goal today. I want to emphasize that today's conversation goes beyond responding to pandemics. Heart disease and cancer are the two leading causes of death in the United States, and many of our country's greatest health challenges are not caused by pathogens, but by the social determinants of health. Fortunately, we already have evidence from the federal, state, and local levels to show that integrating clinical, public health, and social determinants data improves patient outcomes. It helps you follow up with a patient after they've been exposed to an infectious disease. It helps increase patients' adherence to medication when they have a chronic illness. And it helps connect them to social services and community-based mental health services, just to name a few examples. Fortunately, there is strong leadership at the federal level pushing this agenda. We have the CDC's Data Modernization Initiative, the ONC's effort to create qualified health information networks, the Prevent Pandemics Act. All of these help us get closer to this vision. We are at an inflection point on this journey, but we know that this is a complex problem, both politically and technically, and there will continue to be obstacles. So our event today is called Digital Frontiers in Public Health. Frontiers. A frontier can be an exciting place to break new ground, or it can be a place where you encounter unforeseen hurdles. I want to challenge the group today to think about what's next on the frontier. With all the investments and policy changes happening right now, where will we break new ground and where will we get stuck? My personal hypothesis is that our digital frontiers will match closely with the physical borders on a map of the United States. We risk seeing uneven progress across the states and territories because of different starting points in infrastructure and workforce and complex, inconsistent regulations across the states and territories. A study published this month found that 4 out of 5 states do not require providers to share their data with a health information exchange organization. The latest analyses estimate that between $7 billion and $37 billion is needed to modernize our state's public health data systems. But unfortunately, these reports do not estimate or quantify the benefits of these upgrades, either economically or in terms of population health. So we really have no way to measure progress as we make these investments and move forward. If we want to have truly equitable health outcomes across this country, something I know many people in this room have advocated for fiercely for many years, we need to measure and push for equity across geographies, across the states and territories. And to achieve this geographic equity, we need states and territories to have the policies and the infrastructure in place to best use their health data. Patients deserve a system that empowers them to manage their medications, their labs, and their care. And leaders need a system that gives them the right data at the right time to make the right decisions that will save lives. At this very unique moment, we have the technology and the knowledge to move forward on this vision, and we have demand for change coming out of the pandemic. But we also have a long road ahead. Our goal for this session today is to bring together the voices that can build sustained political momentum and sustained political will to achieve the vision of a nationwide health data ecosystem. I'm humbled to have some of the country's leading thinkers in the room for this conversation today. I'm sure there are many other frontiers beyond the ones that I've enumerated that will come up. And I know that we need to bring in diverse voices to help get to practical solutions. That's why at the Ellison Institute, we are excited to start working with our partners to keep this topic on the agenda. Before we kick off the panels, I want to thank Dean Williams and the Harvard Chan School for their tireless commitment to the nation's public health and for their partnership on this event. Although I will say it was not that hard to convince them to visit Los Angeles from Boston in the dead of winter. So welcome. I also want to thank Dr. Agus and the leadership and my colleagues at the Ellison Institute for pushing my thinking on how technology can address some of the nation's greatest healthcare challenges. With that, I'll turn it over to Dean Williams for our first panel. Thank you.